Washington Tabor, TV Engineer, and Davis, Davis Mayor's Quarry, Christie, Tirani, my man, the Quarry, the four bus man. Gloria Patria, Filio, Spiritu Sancto. Intro vivo Laetare Dei. Ad corum in nostro in nomine Domini. Confidier Deo omnipotente, diaconarium semper virgine, diaconic Lord Angelo, diaconi Baptiste, sanctus apostolus perpetua fallo, omnibus sanctus et vobis fratres, fiat et caminibus cogitatione verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ideo praecor diaconarium semper virgine, diaconic Lord Angelo, diaconi Juana Baptista, sanctus apostolus perpetua et fallo, Omne sanctus et vos fratres, orare pro mea Dominum Deum nostrum. Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum nostrum, fribo et nobis omnipotens et intercordes Dominus, Deus tuque versus vivificabis nos. Ostende nobis Domine misericordiam tua. Domine exaudio rationem mea. Dominus vobis cum. Orendo. Laetare Jerusalem, et conventum facite omnes, qui diligitis eum, gaudente cum laetitia, qui in Christitia fuistis, ut exultetis et statia mini et uberibus consolationes vestra, de patus sum in his quae dixi, dicta sunt mihi, in domum Domini ibimus. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritus Sancto. Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Laetare Jerusalem, et conventum facite omnes qui diligitis eum, gaudete cum laetitia, qui in Christitia fuistis, ut exultetis et satia mihi ab uberibus consolationis vestra. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christ eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Concede quaesumus omnipotens Deus, ut qui ex merito nostre actionis affligimur tuae gratiae consolatione respiribus per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui
St. Paul's epistle to the Galatians. Brethren, it is written that Abraham had two sons, the one by a slave girl and the other by a free woman. And the son of the slave girl was born according to the flesh, but the son of the free woman in virtue of the promise. This is said by way of allegory, for these are the two covenants, one indeed from Mount Sinai, bringing forth children unto bondage, which is Hagar. For Sinai is a mountain in Arabia, which corresponds to the present Jerusalem, and is in slavery with her children. But that it, Jerusalem, which is above, is free, which is our mother. For it is written, rejoice, thou barren, that dost not bear. Break forth and cry, thou that dost not travail. For many are the children of the desolate, more than of her that has a husband. Now we, brethren, are the children of promise, as Isaac was. As then he who was born according to the flesh persecuted him who was born according to the Spirit. So also it is now. But what does the Scripture say? Cast out the slave girl and her son, for the son of the slave girl shall not be heir with the son of the free woman. Therefore, brethren, we are not children of a slave girl, but of the free woman, in virtue of the freedom wherewith Christ has made us free. A continuation of the Holy Gospel according to John. At that time, Jesus went away to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, which is that of Tiberias. And there followed him a great crowd, because they were witnessing the signs he worked on those who were sick. Jesus therefore went up the mountain and was sitting there with his disciples. Now the Passover of the Jews was near. And therefore Jesus had lifted up his eyes and seen that a very great crowd had come to him. He said to Philip, whence shall we buy bread that these may eat? But he said this to try him, for he himself knew what he would do. Philip answered him, 200 denarii worth of bread is not enough for them, that each may receive a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, said to him, there is a young boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fishes. But what are they? What are these among so many? Jesus then said, make the people recline. Now there was much grass in the place. The men therefore reclined in number about 5,000. Jesus then took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, distributed them to those reclining, and likewise the fishes, as much as they wished. But when they were filled, he said to his disciples, gather the fragments that are left over, lest they be wasted. They therefore gathered them up, and they filled 12 baskets with the fragments of the 5 barley loaves left over by those who had eaten. When the people therefore had seen the sign which Jesus had worked, they said, this is indeed the prophet who is to come into the world. So when Jesus perceived that they would come to take him by force and make him king, he fled again to the mountain himself alone. Thus for the words of the Holy Gospel. Okay, so an announcement for today. In this year of St. Joseph, we heed our Holy Father's invitation to turn frequently to the foster father of the Redeemer. As a reminder, we will be doing the 33 days consecration to St. Joseph, which will begin for us on Tuesday, March the 30th, using Father Donald Calloway's book. If you want us to obtain one for you, please use one of the envelopes at the back of the church. Fill in your name and phone number and the number of copies you would like, and then enclose $15 per book request. These need to be placed in the offertory basket this weekend to allow enough time for us to order, receive, and distribute the books before the 30 days of preparation begin. To assist us in that consecration, Father McQuaid and I will be leading a discussion and prayers to St. Joseph on Wednesdays, the beginning March 31st at 6:30 p.m. here at St. Patrick's, immediately following the 5:30 Latin Mass. This Friday is the Feast of St. Joseph, Spouse of the Blessed Virgin. As it is a solemnity that is equal to a Sunday, we are not obliged to abstain from meat on Friday as we celebrate the patron of the Universal Church. Please join us at Mass on his feast day. We will have the regular 12:10 Mass at the Cathedral, which will be preceded by Adoration and Confessions beginning at 11 a.m. and 6 p.m. Latin Mass here at St. Patrick's, after which we will have Stations and Benediction at 7 p.m. As you may have noticed, as you came in this morning, there were no printed propers. Instead, we offered a preview copy of this book, The Benedictus, a new monthly devotional that is a companion for daily Mass, containing both the propers and the ordinary, morning and evening prayers, daily meditations, and much more. The copy provided is for this week only. Sophia Institute Press will launch its inaugural issue in August, then following monthly after that. If you are interested, please take a flyer with you and visit their website, praybenedictus.com. So you may take them there in the back there as you came. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Today we celebrate the fourth Sunday in Lent. This is traditionally known as Laetare Sunday because the entrance antiphon begins in Latin, Laetare Jerusalem, et conventum facite omnes diligentes eum, which means, rejoice Jerusalem and be glad for her, all you who love her. The word Laetare in Latin means to rejoice, and as a sign of joy, the priest wears a rose-colored vestment. This is rose, not pink. And the rose signifies a break in the penitential practices of the church, which are symbolized by the violet vestments. How do you get rose? Where does the rose color come from? You take the violet of Advent and Lent, which are both penitential seasons, and you mingle it with the white of Easter or Christmas, and this is where you get the color rose from. Also, Father Wade said, remember, Jesus rose from the dead. He did not paint from the dead. There are two times of the year that the church wears rose vestments, Laetare Sunday in Lent and Gaudete Sunday during Advent, both of which are days of joy and hope. The readings for Mass today all have a current of hope running through them. St. Paul tells the Galatians in the epistle that the reason that they should be hopeful is because we are not the children of the bondwoman, but of the free, and by the freedom wherewith Christ has made us free. In another translation, for freedom's sake, Christ has set us free. Hope is a virtue and a gift that we should all foster in our lives, because if we are able to foster hope, one of the theological virtues, then when tragedy and loss strike, and even when we suffer our own personal sins and failures, we are not simply left fallen and defeated. The devil, the enemy of love, wants to defeat us, and so if he can convince us that we will never be holy and never stop sinning, then we will give up and he wins. He has us exactly where he wants us. That is the end game of the enemy, to get us to give up. It's too hard. God understands, and constant and constant and constant, the excuses that he gives to us. We cannot let him win. We cannot listen to those excuses. However, a person who has hope believes in God's love for us before we sin, when we sin, and after we sin. And even when we do fail in our Christian life of faith, a hopeful person believes that God is still calling them back to himself. A person of hope has faith and is given great assurance in what we see the Lord do in the gospel today, when he not only feeds the multitude, but he feeds them over and above what was their needs. He hear the scripture say, they gathered up therefore, filled 12 baskets with the fragments of the 5 barley loaves, which remained over and above to them that had eaten. He always outdoes us in generosity. God always outdoes us in generosity. We pause during this great season of grace to be joyful, that God's love is greater than our sinfulness. And it is in this realization that we are joyful, comforted, and hopeful. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Credo in unum Deum, Patrem omnipotentem, Factorem caeli et terrae, de divinium omnium et indivinium, et in unum Dominum Iesum Christum filium Dei unigenitum, et ex Patre natum ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deo lumen de lumen, Deum verum de Deo verum, geni cum non factum consubstantialem Patre, terquem omnia facta sunt, qui propter nos homines, proper nostrum salutem de scendi de cepo, et incarnatus est de Spiritu Sanctu ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est, crucifixus etium pro nobis sub puncio velato, passus et sepultus est, resurrexit tertia die secundum scripturas, et ascended in chamber, sedit ad dextra patre, et iturum venturis est cum gloria judicare vivus et mortuos, cuius reine non erat fines, et in spiritum sanctum dominum et vivificantem, qui ex patre filioque procede, qui cum patre et filio simil adoratum, et glorificatum, qui locutus est per orbitas, et unum sanctum catholicum, et apostolicum ecclesiam, confiteor unum baptisma in remissionem peccatorum, et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum, et vitam venturi seculi. Amen. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Laudate Dominum, quia dignius est. Salite nomine eius, omnium suavis est. Omnia quaecumque voluit, fecit in cielo et in terra.
Thank you.
secula seculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Sursum corda. Gratias adamus Domino Deo nostro. Vere vivium et justum et seculum et salutare. Nos tibi semper et ubi fe gratias adus. Domini Sancti Patre Vipotente Terre Deus. Qui corporale, ie unio ita comprimis mentem elevans virtutem largis et premia. Per Christum Dominum nostrum. Perque maestatem tuum lauda dantum. Adoram dominationem. Premuem potestatis, cede generumque virtutem. Acquiata serit, socio ex apatione concelebra. Cum quibus et nostres voces, ut admite quibias de prehamo, supplice confessione dicentes. Sanctus, 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 nominus Deus Sabaoth. Pleni sum cede et terra gloria tua hosanna in excel. Benedictus tu Dei in nomine Domini. Hosanna in excelsis. open repertory. Per omnia saecula saeculorum, oremus. Precep et salutaribus moni qui et divina institutione formata, ad eos dicere. Pater noster qui est in caeli, sanctificetur nomen tuum. Adveniat regnum tuum, via voluntas tua, sicut in caelo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum. Agnus Dei qui colis peccata mundi miserere nobis. Agnus Dei qui colis peccata mundi miserere nobis. Agnus Dei qui colis peccata mundi dona nobis pace.
Ecce Agnus Dei, ecce qui coli peccata mundi, Domine nuntum dignus in interest in peccum meam, sed tanta te verbo sanabitur anima mea. Domine nuntum dignus in interest in peccum meam, sed tanta te verbo sanabitur anima mea. Domine nuntum dignus in interest in peccum meam, sed tanta te verbo sanabitur anima mea.
Thank you.
benedicat vos ad epotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Initium Sancti Evangelii secundum Johannem. In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apud Deus, et Deus erat verbum. Hoc erat in principio apud Deus, omnium verbum sunt factum sunt, et sine ipso factum est vita, quod factum est. In ipso vita erat lux homine, et lux in tenebres lucet, et tenebrae eam non comprehenderum, cuius homo visis ad Deo, quod nomen erat humani. Hic venit testimonium ut testimonium praedicere de lucine, ut omnes praedicerunt tertium, non erat illebus. Sed ut testimonium praedicere de lumine, erat lux vera, quae illuminat omnem hominem venientem in hoc mundo. In mundo erat, et mundus per ipsum factus est, et mundus eam non cognovit. In propria venit, et sui eam non receperunt. Quod potatam receperunt eam, dedit eius potestatem filius Dei fiat. His qui pretus in nomine eius, qui non ex sanguinibus, neque ex bonapitus, necte in bonapit carnis, neque ex bonapis veri, sed ex Deo nati sunt. Et verbum parum factum est, habitavit in nos. Et vidimus gloriam eius, gloriam quasi unigenitia Patri, sed in gratiae et veritate. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, and eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, most sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O most holy Mother of God. Let us pray, O God, our refuge and our strength. Look down with favor upon thy people who cry to thee. Through the intercession of the glorious and immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, of blessed Joseph, her spouse, of thy blessed apostles Peter and Paul, and of all the saints, do thou mercifully and graciously hear the prayers which we pour forth for the conversion of sinners, for the freedom and exaltation of Holy Mother Church, through the same Christ our Lord. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. O Sacred Heart of Jesus, O Sacred Heart of Jesus, O Sacred Heart of Jesus, now the prayer in times of epidemic. Heal not with us, Lord, according to our sins.